Good day and welcome to class in Vassar School online classes for Sedona Science. Today we'll be having chemistry and other chemistry. We'll be talking about the alkyne, about the bastion and hydrocarbons, and we'll be talking about the alkanes, the homologous of alkanes. So, these are the first 10 members of the alkane series. As we said in last class, previous classes, that homologous is a family of organic compounds which follows the structural pattern and they differ from certain members by CH2 group. So this is a homologous series of hydrocarbons which is called the alkane series. Then these are the first 10 members. We have methane, which is having only one carbon atom. This is the molecular formula. This is the condensed structural formula. And this is the number of possible isomers. We have ethane as being the second member with two carbon atoms. So the methane is methane is the first member of this series. So now let's look at the alkanes. Alkanes are aliphatic hydrocarbons. That means they belong to the aliphatic hydrocarbons, the straight chain hydrocarbons. They form a molecular series of saturated hydrocarbons which can be represented by a general formula CnH2n+. So if you want to look for any member of the alkene, you just, where your n is greater than or equal to 1. So you have your if you put 1 in place of n, you have CH4, because 2 times 1 2 plus 2 4. So that is the first member. The second member, which is the ethane, is 2. Then you now do that to if there's any number given. In each alkane member, all carbon atoms are tetrahedrally bonded to the hydrogen and other carbon atoms. So they are tetrahedrally bonded, that means they form tetrahedra on combining with the hydrogen and carbon atoms being present. The general molecular formula CnH remains unchanged for branched alkanes. That means even though the alkane should be branched, the general molecular formula will still be the same. For example, pentane, a straight 5-chain carbon alkane, and 2-methylbutane, a branch 5-carbon alkane, has the same molecular formula C5H12. Yes, when you look at the total number of carbon atoms and the total number of hydrogen atoms present in both compounds, you are still having C5H12. But if you look at their structures are different, but their molecular formula are the same. So let's look at the first member, methane. Methane is the simplest compound in the alkane series with molecular formula of CH4. Besides being a component of petroleum gas, it is the major constituent of natural gas, which issues from the ground in great quantities in certain parts of the world. Yes, when we were saying, when we were talking about exploration of crude oil, when they are removing crude oil from the ground, the natural gas is the one at the top of the crude oil. So methane is the major constituent of the natural gas, although it's present in petroleum gas. If you should remember when we talk about fractionalization of petrol, we said we have methane, ethane, propane, butane, and ethylene present in the petroleum gas. But it's the major constituent, but methane is now the major constituent of natural gas. Methane is produced during the decomposition of plant matter in the absence of air. So when plant matter decomposes in the absence of air, methane is produced. It is often given up from swamps and is known as marsh gas. So this is another name for methane. In the IUP, the last letter we did talk about IUP system nomenclature, we said that there is a system of giving names. So we said that methane is also known as marsh gas. So due to that, methane is being given off from swamps. That's why it is being called marsh gas. It is also found in poorly ventilated coal mines known as the dreaded fire damp, which is the main cause of explosion in these mines. So in mines that are not well ventilated, the methane causes the explosions of the mines. So let's look at its laboratory preparation. Methane is usually prepared by heating anhydrous sodium methanoate with solar lime. is the solar lime is a mixture of sodium hydroxide and calcium oxide, but the mixture acts in the reaction mainly as the source of sodium hydroxide. Due to the reactivity of sodium hydroxide, the main component that is reacting with sodium ethanol to produce methane is sodium hydroxide, but due to its strong alkaline, due to its strong base and it reacts with glass, they mix it with calcium oxide. If you should remember in your carbon series, what we talked about lime water or CaOH2, but calcium oxide is also known as lime, so or quick lime, so that was where the name got it from, soda lime, because sodium hydroxide is also known as caustic soda. So now let's look at the equation. So on eating sodium ethanoate and sodium hydroxide, you from the soda lime, you have sodium carbonate and methane. You can see that the main component is the sodium hydroxide, but due to its reactivity, it is mixed with calcium oxide to reduce the amount of its releasing the reaction. So this is the picture. They said mixture of sodium methanoate and solar lime. You eat it, then you have methane and water. This preparation must be carried out in the foam cupboard and only by a teacher. The reason why it's carried out in the foam cupboard is that the gas is poisonous, so you have to. It might be poisonous because any poisonous gas is only taken, the preparation is only taken out in the foam cupboard. So this is the picture of the laboratory preparation of methane. Let's look at the physical properties of methane. Methane is a colorless, odorless, and tasteless non-poisonous gas. Methane is lighter than air. It is slightly soluble in water but dissolves readily in ether and alcohol. Its melting point is -104 degrees Celsius and its boiling point is 161.4 degrees Celsius. Methane, like carbon dioxide, also traps infrared radiation reflected by the earth. As a result, methane also contributes to the greenhouse effects. So let's look at its chemical properties. Combustion reaction. Combustion is an endothermic reaction in which large amount of energy is released. The general equation for combustion of alkanes or hydrocarbons is represented as follows. We have our alkane here having the formula CXHY or the hydrocarbon plus O2. This is just the balancing. So if you want to know your X and Y, through this equation you balance your combustion reaction. So methane, for example, burns in air oxygen with a pale non-luminous flame to produce steam, carbon dioxide, and a lot of heat. Because it is not the carbon atom, so the flame will not be that luminous, but if it has like 2 or 3, it will be a little luminous. So, but the production being produced is the same carbon dioxide and a lot of it. So you can see the methane is a gas. We have to oxygen to give us steam is the vapor form of water, and we have CO2. So you can see that the products are all in gaseous state. A mixture of methane and air or oxygen may explode violently when ignited. This is the main cause of explosion in the coal mines. In the previous slides we talked about, where I said methane is known as fire that be poorly ventilated coal mines. Due to when this methane now reacts with oxygen or air, it explodes violently. So that's why coal mines which are poorly ventilated are being exploded due to the reaction of methane and oxygen. Still on the chemical properties, now we have substitution reaction. Methane reacts with chlorine in presence of ultraviolet light, which is a catalyst. So the catalyst used here is the ultraviolet light. To yield a mixture of products. These products are formed by successive replacement or displacement of hydrogen atoms in the methane molecule by chlorine atoms. So, from the word substitution, they remove hydrogen Hydrogen is removed from the methane molecule and is substituted by chlorine. So let's look at the first equation here. This is methane reaction with chlorine. It will give you hydrogen chloride and chloromethane. On reacting this chloromethane with chlorine again, we have dichloromethane acting with So you can see that the final result is tetrachloromethane plus hydrogen chloride. The catalyst being used here, don't forget, is ultraviolet light. A substitution reaction involves the displacement of an atom or group by another atom or group. So as I said, substitution, you remove one and replace another. That's what is also taking place here. They remove one atom or group and replace it with another atom or group uses of methane. So we can see the few uses of methane. Now let's know about them. Methane is used as well, either itself or mixed with other gases. We know it's present in petroleum gas, which we said when liquefied we call it the liquefied petroleum gas, which is being sold in our filling stations or our nearby gas outlets, where the gas used for cooking. Methane is present, so it's used as well, either itself or mixed with other gases. It is used in making hydrogen, carbon black, carbon phosphate, alkynes, hydrocyanic acid, trichloromethane or chloroform. That's the name for trichloromethane. It is used as an anesthetic, which is used in surgical operations. Tetrachloromethane is an organic solvent for grease. So this is where we solve the class for today. I hope you've understood the first member, you've understood the alkane series, and we've learned about their first member. So the chemical properties of alkanes are the same. They only undergo combustion and substitution. So as you said, the chemical properties of alkanes tend to be similar. And the physical properties now are differs. The physical properties differs. So thank you for watching. To meet in the next class. Like and subscribe to this channel to see or watch other videos. Contact us on WhatsApp for inquiries through this number, and visit our website for more information. Thank you.